got some Folgers bagged coffee here. Coffee in the style of tea. We'll see how it turns out.
That's a good cup, Joe.
3 brothers hiked the John Muir Trail with one another.
I hope y'all are hungry.
Oh yeah, I'm there.
There's some oatmeal here, trail mix, dried apples, Nutella.
Our morning routine usually takes about 2 hours, and we never got faster.
You motherfucker. That's just how much time it takes to, like, fucking get up and be like, okay, I gotta fucking hike a bunch of miles, clean up all this shit, and, like, go.
Right now we're headed to Crabtree Meadows, which is gonna be the base for the ascent to Mount Whitney, the tallest point in the continental United States. It's an 8.2 mile trip. We're about to ascend for about 4 miles. Then we're gonna level off, get up and down, but this first stretch is gonna be tough, but it's a beautiful day. Birds are chirping.
Cotton across.
Kyle's already got his cross caught.
Trying to find a place to cross this river without having to take off our shoes.
That looks really good.
I can't believe we're doing Mount Whitney tomorrow. That's fucking crazy.
At least it's kind of the hardest thing first.
I mean, I think it's gonna be hard. I don't think it's gonna be the hardest.
How about that? Like, will be.
I think we're gonna have some days that are pretty damn hard.
Yeah, some of the passes for sure.
Right now we're down here. We're gonna work our way up. Top of Mount Whitney, and that is us tomorrow.
Yeah, I still just had no idea what the trail was at this point. None of us did.
Gotta be to the top.
How you feel? This is a tough ascent. I think my life flashed before my eyes twice, but I'm back on trail now. I was off trail for a second.
We gave our first patch out this day
to Brett's dad's son, Brett. We should probably explain what Drain the Hetch is, because that's the name of the show. But to explain what Drain the Hetch is, I'm going to have to explain who John Muir was.
Born in 1838, he was a Scottish immigrant who was a bit of a child prodigy with machines. He built all kinds of wacky clocks and whimsical contraptions, and at age 29, while sharpening a cog or something, a piece of metal from a file flew off and pierced his eyeball. This event started him off on a life of scientific and spiritual exploration. For many years, the Yosemite Valley and the surrounding mountain range were his home. John Muir is sort of credited as the person who popularized the idea of the national parks, writing inspiring things like,
"The clearest way into the universe is through a forest wilderness."
And that really hyped people up about preserving wild, untrammeled nature. But late in his life, his beloved Hetch Hetchy Valley, right next to Yosemite Valley, was filled with water and turned into a reservoir. He had fought against it for over a decade and finally he lost. A year later, at age 76, he died.
106 years later, something had to change. We felt like we had no choice. We had to drain the hedge.
Using our own embroidery machine, we crafted around 40 unique patches on denim because we heard John preferred jeans for glacial work.
We hope by passing out these patches, we can spread the word about the Hetch Hetchy, drain that sucker, and finally free John Muir's ghost.
Little tip we learned from a lot of other hiking vloggers, Jupiter Hikes, Darwin, which is cold soaking couscous.
Couscous.
I like to add soup mixes. This one in particular, it's called a vegetable recipe mix.
Now I like to get just a little bit of this, not too much.
I think you put all of it, but I put all of it. We'll see if it's too much.
I'm just doing that.
Just a little bit above it.
Just mix it up.
Put the top on, shake it. And there you have it.
And we'll check back in at lunchtime. We'll check back in at lunchtime to see how the couscous turned out.
That actually looks pretty good.
Yeah, add a little water and stir it.
Try a bite.
It's not ready.
It is.
It's not. It's fucking hard.
Actually, not bad.
Do we need to say, like, why we're out on the trail at all? Like, we're not just draining the hedge.
No, I don't think so. I think it's obvious why people are out on the trail. Everyone's in pain and everyone's trying to deal with their pain in their own way. And some people need to be out in nature to nurture that.
I was just trying to get away from the rat race, you know, the hustle and bustle everyday life.
It takes a couple days to get out of that and get in a human state of mind and not a capitalist cog. It's nice to just be focusing on one thing, and it's so crucial that you don't really need to think about anything else.
I feel like something like this is a thing that could change a person, and so it's weird to be in it and wondering if the transformation is taking place.
This was an interesting place because everyone was camped out there. There was so many people, and
it was weird to be at like a group campsite. Zach and Kyle getting in their second grundle dip.
Yeah, this was a pretty cold one.
Oh yeah, this was one of the coldest.
This was kind of the start of like my butt chafing like really hard from like scrubbing my butt too hard with my wool sock.
Yeah, you had to get out of there quick and put your clothes on before the mosquitoes fucking drained all your blood.
So before the camp trip, Kyle dehydrated a bunch of food. He dehydrated apples, beef jerky, and one of the things that he has here is dehydrated spaghetti sauce.
Took about 12 hours dehydrating. Pretty fat bag of ground beef. That's that Whitney fuel right there.
This is when like the hunger started to set in a bit more. Because you're like, okay, I'm out here. Like, we need to start eating like a lot.
Here's some of Kyle's dried apples.
A little bit sauce is a little watery, but it's fine.
It really is hilarious how dumb the fucking bug nets look.
It was really gross drinking your water through the bug net for some reason.
Yeah, you guys were talking about doing it, and I'm like, I don't want to do that. Like, I don't want to be sucking on my bug net.
I did it. It was like, it felt just wrong.
How much sauce? I kind of want meat. Don't steal my meat.
Right. How dumb they look is almost how uncomfortable it is wearing them.
This is gonna be fucking good. You wanna try it, Ryan?
Tastes like meat sauce.
Yeah, it does taste like meat sauce.
But being enclosed in a small tent and having to eat is kind of shitty, especially whenever like everything outside is so like vast and like cool looking.
In here we got a fly. It's okay, the fly can stay. Oh yeah, it's fucking good. Whew, fucking needed this. These fucking mosquitoes wanna fuck me and suck me. It's actually one right fucking all the time outside the tent. Okay, cool. mosquitoes are fucking ravage out here. I can't eat without having a mosquito fucking like attacking me, so I'll eat in the tent. I mean, I gotta eat. I gotta have my peace when I eat. What I'm eating here is a Noor side mixed with Kyle's homemade meat sauce. How about that, Jupiter Hikes?
I had no fucking idea what we were in store for, still.
Looks pretty juicy.